Thank you, Madam Speaker. I rise to ask question number 15 of 2018, sending my name to this order paper. And the question is addressed to the Acting Minister for Local Government, Housing, Environment, Infrastructure and Transport. Would the Minister inform Parliament of the total output of electricity of all generators purchased by Fiji Electricity Authority to date? Why the generators are unable to meet the electricity demand during power blackouts?
Thank you. The Acting Minister for Local Government, Housing, Environment, Infrastructure and Transport.
Thank you, Madam Speaker. I'd like to thank the Honourable Member for this question. This question obviously came through the Business Committee. As usual, Honourable Prem Singh does put two questions in one question. The first question is about the total output of electricity of all generators, Madam Speaker. The total maximum generation output for FEA is 239.89 megawatts, whereas the maximum total demand or load is 177.12 megawatts. Why are the generators unable to meet the electricity demand during blackouts? Now, Honourable Prem Singh, I just want to correct you on something. When you ask generators, they're generators not only driven by diesel. So this figure that I've given you is electricity generated by all generators. Yeah? I think you probably have a misconception there. Madam Speaker, when there is a blackout, of course, when there is a blackout, the electricity obviously goes off. Now, one of the unfortunate things is, of course, in the past, we've never had redundancies built in. So as you know, the major source of supply of electricity in Viti Levu is from Manasagu, where 55% of the renewable sources, including some other renewable sources of energy, comes from Manasagu. 45% is from thermal sources, or fossil fuel as we call it. Now, when the main grid, the line that comes from Manasagu goes to Vunda, goes to Suva, if there's a lightning strike, as you know that the Honourable Minister for Natural Disaster Management, the Honourable Prime Minister, has also mentioned in this house, because of the frequency of inclement weather, we do get a lot of lightning strikes, for example, in the middle of Viti Levu. It cannot be helped. The unfortunate thing, though, is we don't have any redundancy. So we have only one line. If that line gets struck by a lightning, electricity goes off. Most countries in the world, you have a redundancy. So one goes off, the other one picks up. Now, in order to, unfortunately this was not done, and in order to build a second line, it'll cost us US $100 million. Now, there is, of course, a capital projects plan in place, and we expect this line to be constructed in the next 5 years. US $100 million, in today's terms, about 200 million Fijian dollars. That's the kind of capital input is required in FEA to stop any lightning strike stopping us from getting any electricity. Now, when there is a strike and you have a blackout on Viti Levu, because obviously Vanua Levu, Tavuni, Ovalau are independent of Viti Levu. And by the way, Vanua Levu is run by diesel generators, including Lambasa and Savusavu. Of course, Tavuni has now Somo Somo, and Ovalau, of course, is run by diesel generators also. Now, there is what we call FEA Activator National Blackout Restoration Plan, whereby all major power stations carry out its black start process to normalize the power. Now, it's not like a generator at home. You know, when the power goes off, and if you have a standby generator, I don't remember if you have one, but those people who do have, as soon as electricity goes off in your home, the other one kicks in. It's almost instantaneous. You cannot do that with the national grid. Just because you have a standby generator, it does not instantaneously kick in. It takes a while because it carries obviously a lot of load. The restoration of power supply is coordinated by a national control center at Vunda and takes place in a systematic and methodical manner, to ensure that at all times there is a balance between the amount of generation capacity on the line and the load that is reconnected to the power system. Because when the power goes off, when you bring it back up, you have to slowly do it. That's why sometimes it takes a few hours. You cannot instantaneously put it up because it will collapse. That's how electricity works. Any imbalance between the generation and the load will result in partial or total collapse of the power system, meaning the restoration process has to be restarted all over again. This restoration could be at a regional level or national level and takes around 2 to 3 hours. And as we've seen recently, it happened about 3 weeks ago when we in fact had the Commonwealth Education Ministers meeting when it actually happened. Thank you.